Welcome to P-Town, one of the best gay travel destinations on the planet.
With beautiful beaches, even a gay nude beach option, along with an impressive number of art galleries, restaurants, and a thriving nightlife scene, P-Town surely has something for everyone. The journey to P-Town is in itself part of the fun and typically starts in Boston at one of two companies. Both offer fast ferry service over to the extreme tip of Cape Cod. The trip costs $118 round trip and takes about an hour and a half. Both operators are pretty similar, so just take whichever one times best for your trip.
On arrival in P-Town, you exit McMillan Pier in the center of town on Commercial Street. Commercial Street is the main street where you'll find much of what you're looking for in terms of shopping, dining, and entertainment.
P-Town is very easy to navigate on foot or bike. There are also a good number of pedicabs available for short trips.
Located just one block from all the action on Commercial Street, we find our accommodations at The Gas Lamp. This gay-owned, Victorian-style boutique bed and breakfast offers 8 guest rooms, mostly with shared facilities, and a clothing-optional sun deck and garden with hot tub.
Jeff and his partner Jim include a delicious breakfast each morning as well, with an assortment of fruits and yogurt, pastries, and gourmet egg dishes. We find it an excellent value in an otherwise expensive P-Town. Our nightly rate at the tail end of Bear Week is $254.
The Brass Key Guest House, just a few doors down from The Gas Lamp, is another great, although more expensive option. They also have a fun bar called Shipwreck.
Depending on your arrival time, your first stop in P-Town after checking into your accommodations should be the insanely popular Tea Dance at the Boat Slip Resort and Beach Club. Held daily from 4 to 7 p.m. in the summer, tea is how many wild evenings in P-Town begin. Come as you are and expect the unexpected at Provincetown's biggest outdoor party.
Order the Signature Planner's Punch, which you may know is just a rum punch. It's ridiculously easy to drink given its fruity contents. So what's in a planner's punch, you ask? This sweet cocktail is made with equal parts white and spiced rum. It looks like maybe doubles in our case. Add a splash of grenadine and then equal parts orange juice and pineapple juice. Next, you mix, pour, and garnish with cherries and orange slices. It's really starting to feel like vacation now. Finally, you add straws and pour Bacardi 151 down the straw as best you can for that first highly potent sip. At $16 a pop, it's not the cheapest drink in P-Town, but it is the iconic way to start your first night.
For us, one of the best things about tea is that nearly everyone in town comes each and every night to socialize, and it's very easy to meet people. It's no wonder why tea has been a P-Town institution for nearly 50 years.
After tea, it's time for dinner at Tin Pan Alley. We sit at the bar and listen to live music, which they have here nightly. The bartender Justin takes great care of us and gives us plenty of insider tips on P-Town. For dinner, we order the chicken with mashed potatoes and broccoli and the Cape Cod salad. Both are incredible and highly recommended.
For entertainment, don't miss a drag show or theater performance at one of the many venues in town. We opt for Diva at Crown and Anchor. In this all-out sequin-soaked show, the queens perform hit songs from Beyoncé, Lady Gaga, and Tina Turner, just to name a few. The show lasts just 1 hour, followed by a meet-and-greet and photos outside.
Next, sing along to your favorite show tunes at the Wave Video Bar, also in the Crown and Anchor Complex. Afterwards, the best place to end your night before everything closes at 1 a.m. is on the dance floor at A House. Along with tea at the Boat Slip, no trip to P-Town is complete without a stop at A House, the premier gay nightclub here for over 40 years.
To recover from a huge first night out, we head to Pepe's Wharf, a relaxing waterfront lunch spot just east of the McMillan Pier. We treat ourselves to refreshing Pim's Cup cocktails, an arugula salad, and then split a BLT with fries. Everything hits the spot, and just what we need before the long trek out to Boy Beach.
Located on a stretch of sand far away from the main beach at Heron Cove, follow the boys through the marshy wetlands to the gay nude beach known as Boy Beach. Nudity is not technically legal here, but its remote location gives nearly, I'd say, half of the guys the confidence to sun and swim naked. Check the tides though before venturing out. That's one of the best travel tips we can give you.
Back in town, it's time for one final tea dance, followed by dinner at our hands-down favorite restaurant in P-Town. Sal's on the Water offers both indoor and outdoor dining. We opt for indoor as it looks more romantic as well as air-conditioned.
First up, we ordered two Negronis and then split the arugula salad and chicken parmesan with pomodoro pasta. They also bring complimentary locally made fudge with sea salt if you have no room left for dessert.
This popular Italian restaurant requires advance reservations by phone or in person and is cash only, so be forewarned. We promise you the extra effort will be worth it.
After dinner, head to Gifford House for a martini and a relaxed atmosphere. They have nightly entertainment upstairs with their nightclub Purgatory and well-known underwear party downstairs. As we can't seem to catch a break with the weather and are looking for more of a date night option, we brave the rain to enjoy more live music at the Club Provincetown. Amazingly, they have jazz tonight with a Hammond B3 organ, which Andy learned how to play from his grandma. If you love music, the Club Provincetown may be your best bet, and it's a perfect way to end our last night. On our final morning, we grab some cold brew over at Joe's on Commercial Street. They have a great patio for people watching, and it's a beautiful day today, which makes for a really enjoyable return on the ferry to Boston. The captain just came on the loudspeaker to say how perfect the weather is, and it's as good as it gets. The view from the outdoor deck, though, isn't bad either. See you next time, P-Town. Well, that's a wrap on our first trip to P-Town together. We've both been here before with friends, and we can say it's truly a magical place for couples, singles, groups of friends, and the entire LGBTQ plus community. As a fun fact, P-Town is home to the zip code with the highest concentration of same-sex couple households in the entire United States. It's truly a diverse and welcoming place.
Have you been to P-Town? Where are your favorite places to go? Let us know in the comments. And thank you to everyone who gave us their recommendations on Instagram and Threads. If you're not following us already, we'll drop links in the description. And of course, subscribe here on YouTube if you haven't already so you don't miss any of our upcoming travels.
Also, thank you to our channel members, Frank and James, and thank you for watching. We'll see you on the next adventure.